So Franco Baresi takes the first kick. He was off with cramp just a moment ago. He's been out injured for most of this tournament. Oh, he's over the top. You see what I mean? How does he live that down now? If it turns to be a man who's had an absolutely illustrious career in the game.
That might be the worst penalty I've ever seen in my life.
Leading from the front, but not leading successfully.
No more experienced player in world football than Franco Baresi. And you just look at that, and the nerves have got through to him then.
You name it, and he's won it, except the World Cup. And now maybe, at the end of that illustrious career, Franco Baresi has cost Italy that prize. We'll see. Number 15, Marcio Santos. Comes up for this one. And it's saved by Pagliuca! Well, there might be a relief. And certainly a reprieve for Baresi. But what you've also got out there, Rob, who are so tired.
That's a good save, but he's hit it close. Keeper stood his ground, he hasn't committed early.
Albertini has gone over to collect the ball over by the far touchline. And as their limbs are exhausted, so is their mind. So it stands at 0-0 after one penalty. Well, a reprieve maybe for Baresi. As Albertini, 22 years old. Short run-up. And a successful penalty puts Italy one ahead. So his job is done successfully. I think it's Romario next.
Nice call. And
that was a good one.
Short run-up. He even allows himself to see the keeper give himself up on it.
So Romario, a name that's been on everybody's lips in this part of the world, particularly over the last few days, who missed that chance just before the end of extra time.
Missed two or three against Sweden in the previous game.
Romario. Whoa, what a cheeky one. He did a little shuffle coming up and then got a cannon in off the post. One. Ivani comes forward now. Off the post there.
Not much room for error.
None at all. Another inch and that would have hit the post and come out. Ivani now for Italy. Came on as a substitute. Strange World Cup he's had. Played the first game, has dropped ever since. Comes on for this one and now has this. Critical penalty. And does his country proud. So imagine the pressure that now puts on the next Brazilian. As Pagliuca goes back to it again, hitting it exactly where the goalkeeper had been standing.
I tell you, Brian, that one hits him in the face if he stands still.
It's Branco. And the only thing we'll know about him is he'll certainly take it with his left foot.
Might be too close in for him, actually.
Okay, scored 2-1 for Italy. And the third penalty coming. Brazilians watching, all linking arms. Solidarity, that's there, the lads on the bench. Wishing Branco well, I'm sure. Coolness itself. Coolness itself. 2-2. Takes such a long run with all his free kicks. And also with the penalty.
That's a beauty.
Isn't that a lovely one?
This is a beauty.
Now, Daniel Mazzara, 33 years old. A hero for Milan in the European Cup final. Scored one goal in this World Cup. And has worked his socks off, as Ron would say, as the lone man up front. Well, if he's got the mental energy and the physical energy left, got a really important job to do for his team here now. Mazzaro. It's saved by Taffarel.
The Brazilians are jumping around in delight. That feeling of solidarity grows.
Brian, the goalkeeper here must have been 2 yards off his line before he's even kicked it. He stepped forward and then went sideways. And there's a linesman. I mean, I've never ever seen a retake in a penalty shootout. You never see it, do you?
Coming into the critical last penalties, Brazil will have a one-goal lead. 2-2 the score. But Brazil still have this penalty up their sleeve. Well, it's the captain, Dunga. Plays his football in Germany.
He's done it. It's a goal. And Roberto Baggio will be the last one. There's delight amongst the Brazilians, as you would expect. And dejection amongst the Italians. So it's quite a simple equation now. If Roberto Baggio misses, if Roberto Baggio scores, Pelé's reaction to the last one. The last Brazilian simply has to score himself, and Brazil win the World Cup. So the pendulum has swung wildly against Italy now. Roberto Baggio, the saviour of Italy throughout this tournament. He's missed it, and Brazil win the World Cup. Stays rooted to the spot, has hardly moved. Italy are dejected. The delight from the Brazilians. It all started with Baresi's missed penalty right at the start, and ended with Baggio's missed penalty at the finish. Brazil win the World Cup for an unprecedented fourth time on a penalty shootout for the first time.